Okay, guys, so we're outside again, and we have perfect sunny day, and it is, your title is it a pit? I'm an idiot. So is it, it's a pit master?
Right, I'm the pit master for Grilla Grills.
Pit master for Grilla Grills, and he drove all the way. This is Shane, by the way. And your real company does sauce too, right?
That's correct. Draper's Barbecue. We started in the 70s. My grandfather started the company.
Right.
I kind of picked it up when I moved back home after the military and made a sauce and rub line, and that kind of took off and got into all things pit related.
Right. So this is the man that Grilla Grills goes to for all things cooking, all things food, all things tech. He's the consultant of the company, and I got him. I got him for a day. So we're going to be doing a lot of stuff. We're going to unbox first, right?
Right.
We're going to unbox first. So so we're going to bring you in close. Oh, do you like my shirt? Look at that. What's it say? Gorillas, do it low and slow. That's, and I'm going to let you, whatever that means to you, have at it. But yeah, I got a shirt. Okay, so this is like really simple stuff. So if I can do it, he's going to tell me what to do. If I can do it, you guys can do it. Let's get started. All right, so the things in here, what were these goodies? Are this like food in here or what?
This is going to be some of the supplies. There's no telling what the factory sent you, so you may have some surprises.
All right, let's cut that open first. Sorry. I'm all excited. He's the knife guy, by the way. What
now
do we got?
Now you can cut to the hat.
Look at it, I got a hat. All right, going to the hat.
Beautiful grill with the cover.
Oh, my head's too big. All right, well, I'm going to size this. What else we got? What is that?
This is the cover for your...
Oh, they did give me a cover.
Yeah, absolutely.
Awesome. I didn't ask, but...
These things are great. They're weatherproof, and I do a really good job keeping the rain and stuff off the pit when it's left outside.
So, now that it's open, do we cut the front open, or what do we do?
No, actually, the best part of these is the way they're packed. They really thought at the factory about how to get your grill in as fast as possible.
Get your grill on.
Yeah, absolutely. So what we're going to do is we'll kind of wiggle the box up from the corners.
Oh.
And it'll slide right up.
Oh, yeah. That was easy.
The need for, a lot of cutting and fighting is taken care of.
So we didn't have to cut anything. We just lifted the box up and it comes undone.
Yep.
Now do we take these all out too?
Yeah, you take the supporting pieces out.
All right, so we got that off.
All right. And there is... the Silverbac, as far as the cook cabinet.
Look at it. Ah, check it out. Hey, baby. Welcome to the world. What are we going to name it? George?
George of the Jungle?
This is my, yeah, we're doing George. This is George of the Jungle right here. This is the new member of the Scalfani family. Oh, look how heavy that is. It's a nice heavy door. And then all these have stuff in them?
Yep. This is going to be the pieces that build the cabinet underneath the Silverbac itself.
Okay, and what is this? Oh, that's a smokestack, huh?
That is.
Look at how beautiful. Okay, I'm going on record saying that the website doesn't do this justice.
No, and that's the one comment we get, Jack, is that, one, the picture on the website doesn't give the scale of the unit. Everyone thinks these things are very, very small.
This
but really
is a
not.
Massive stack. I mean, this is a, what do you call it? The smoke pipe? What do you call this?
Yeah, it's the air vent.
Hold on. I need a knife.
Here we go.
It's the air vent, right. But let me show you something, guys. Look at this. This is bigger than I've ever seen on any smoker. Look in my hands. That is solid built.
Right.
Look at that. Even a gasket.
Yeah, they don't use the really light gauge steel on these, and that's the one thing I really appreciate.
Nice.
They're actually built to last a lifetime.
Hello! This is already put together. The body is already put together, meaning you just got to take the plastic off the, I call this the drip pan, right?
Right. The heat deflector and drip pan.
Okay, so you're looking at this is the hopper.
The hopper, yeah.
All right.
But so. It also doubles as a nice table. And that's why they made it out of stainless, so it doesn't get beat up and the paint all chipped off.
It does get hot, though.
It does get warm, yeah.
Nice. All right, let's open this. What's inside? How's it look? Oh, look, guys. Oh, my gosh. All right, well, what is this first?
This is your catch can. So you would put an aluminum can in here and all your drippings fall
like,
into this. And
like you can do like a Coke can or something?
Yeah, yeah. Totally use a Coke can. And you throw it away in the end instead of a big bucket that you've got to wash, right?
Oh, my gosh. I love that. And all the tools. Look, everybody. All the tools are in here. Look how easy this is.
Yeah.
I can't believe that. Look at that. This is like really big. It flares out more than most hoppers. So right. What? How big is this?
So this is a 20-pound hopper. You can put a full 20-pound bag of pellets in there.
Wow.
It's going to give you roughly 20 hours of cook time with a burn rate of about a pound an hour at 225 to 250.
Wait a minute. You mean I can put the whole 20-pound bag of pellets in here and not have to worry about it?
Right.
That is massive.
Right.
That auger is like heavy duty.
So that auger, in my opinion, is kind of what Grilla Grills is. They don't skimp on the important pieces. They make sure to bulk up and overbuild the most essential parts of the unit, but still give you a lot of bang for your buck.
Oh, and stuck under the lid right there is my model number and serial number.
Right. And this is what you would use if you ever had to call a factory and you had a question or a problem.
Right.
And what I love is when you call the factory, you're not speaking to just a $10 an hour temp. You're speaking to the engineer that designed this, Mark.
Oh.
And when you go to our website and ask a question of a pit master about cooking,
right,
I respond.
Okay, cool.
So that they're really into making sure you get natural and organic responses, no fluff, no mess.
So they're not just a business, they love what they do.
They love people.
Okay, so once again, here's the tools. And yet, the back is all cut out for each section of your tools. And instead of having to flip back and forth to see what it is, it's got the name of what's in there. So right there it says, what to say? It's the gaskets. All right, and then over here is the quarter inch. And then over here is quarter inch. And then this is open end wrench. They got it all labeled. Whoever did this uses the product. This is one of those things that most people, when they develop things, you're like, hello, do you ever use your own product?
So these guys do.
Look at the side up, right?
Correct.
All right.
So we'll put this up here, and it's just secured with two little bolts.
That's these things.
Yep.
People are like, dude, you don't know what a bolt is? I know what a bolt is. You do it by hand first?
Yeah.
Okay, we do the same on the other side, right?
Exact same thing on the other side here.
I can do that. Look at this, guys. I'm doing work. This is it? I mean, is this like the hardest thing we're going to do, or why?
I mean, there's lifting. You have to, like, lift the actual Silverbac itself onto the cabinet, but, you know, that's really it. We've got on each side here.
Oh, you screw the sides in?
Yep.
And get that all together. Nice. All right, now once everything's together like this, all hand tightened, go through and tighten everything with the wrench or the screwdriver, okay? So we're gonna do that right now. Okay, guys, so it's time to put the doors on. I wanna show you, there's this little tab here. See that? It pushes in, that's to put the door on, and then this one doesn't. You only need one side to push in, okay? So the stiff end is the end that goes in the bottom. So you'll know your left from your right. So this right here, see the handle's here. This makes this the right door. So I put it in the hole here, right? Oh boy. That is too easy. All right. And then you lift, whoops. You lift, push it in.
Yep.
There we go. And let it pop out. Where are you? Come on.
Right
there, pop right in the hole. So you're going to help me? I can grab the handle here?
Yeah, absolutely.
You have the hard part. You're bigger and stronger than them. I'm going to grab it. Kind of like this though. Okay, so line you up first. I'll hold my end.
Okay.
Make sure you're set in right.
All right, go your way, your direction.
Oh, this way, right? Oh, I can see it.
Right,
I can see it. No, seriously, are we in?
Yep.
That was it? We're in?
Make sure you're lined up. Yep.
We're in? We're in.
That's it.
Okay, so what keeps this from toppling over now?
Well, now we're gonna put our bolt it all together.
Okay, so how many bolts are in here?
There's going to be four that secure the cabinet and the cooker together.
All right, so there's four bolts in here that go straight up into the big cooker. So we're going to put that in right now. Okay, so the next step is, while he's tightening that, we got four screws on the top of the doorway. This is the magnets for the top of the door, and it's going to set right in here. It screws right in. There's four screws, so we'll go ahead and attach that right now. Silver goes here. All right, you just go inside, guys, and just screw it in.
Yep.
Okay, smokestack's got two holes here, two holes there. and you just stick it in, you'll go inside and screw it in, or go outside really and screw that in.
So one of the questions we got when we did the big Father's Day giveaway was the wives and children want to know, could they put this together and have it ready for dad, like as a surprise?
Right.
And a mother and a, you know, a young kid could totally put this together.
No, totally. This is probably the hardest of them all, is the hanging basket. Be careful. Don't cut yourself. And we're clear. That was easy.
Last step is the grates.
The grates.
The grates. The grates of wrath.
Yeah. Look at that. Is that a great grate or what?
It's greatly great.
That's beautiful. All right. So now our video, we're going to cook on this. What are we cooking?
Well, we're going to do, we challenged each other, right? I said, we're going to try to do four chickens.
Right.
And three racks of ribs. And you said, where's this all going to fit?
Yeah, you ain't fitting that in here.
No. I mean, think about it. You get some chickens over here, maybe some ribs over here. But you're a little crowded. But you can always throw this in here.
What? Where'd that come from? That is that a part of the package?
Absolutely.
Where was that? I didn't even see the second shelf.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
So another whole rack of ribs or two up here if you wanted to, or you can even put two chickens up here really easily.
All right, wait a minute. Did they send it to me because I'm doing the show, or does this come naturally to everybody?
No, they don't believe in a lot of accessories like add-ons in the purchase price.
Right.
Everything you've got comes with the actual grill itself.
Because, I mean, usually you got to pay for this.
Right.
That just comes with the master package. Okay.
Well, and not even to mention, this is an upgraded rack. This is a full stainless steel rack, and they're very heavy. And there's no add-on to that. There's no cheap grate and then a good grate. You only get the good grate.
I don't believe that 20-pound bag will go in there, so prove it to me.
All right, not a problem. And you said your favorite is mesquite, right?
Wow.
I don't know. Might not make it.
That thing's huge. That's a big hopper. God, Dennis Pecky. Ain't even that big.
That's right, Pecky. Look at her hopper.
Yeah. There it is. Okay, I just want to be real clear. I'm totally blown away. Look at the storage space below the Silverback. So the belly of a Silverback holds how much?
60 pounds of pellets.
60 pounds of pellets right there. Look at that. Okay, so now are we ready to cook yet?
Just about. We recommend firing up the grill, letting it run for about 30 to 50 minutes at about 300 degrees. Just want to fire off any assembly oils or any funk that may be inside that may have occurred during the manufacturing or shipping process.
Okay, so we're going to fire it up right now?
Absolutely.
All right, and how long do we run it for before we can put food on?
About 30 to 50 minutes.
Got that? 30 to 50 minutes. You got to rev it up. You got to get the engine running.
All right. So the startup process for the Silverback is terribly hard. Ready? It's already plugged in. We got a green light. I'm breaking a sweat already.
That's it?
That's it.
That's it?
That's it.
Okay. So then you control the temperature up and down. It's fully digital?
Yep. Absolutely digital. So it comes on automatically at 350 for the burn-in process.
Right. So we're going to 350.
We're just
going
to let it go to 350 and we'll check back on it in a few minutes.
So what is that flashing? What is that now?
That's telling us that it's in its warm-up cycle. That's why it's flashing.
Right.
And it's letting us know that it's not at the temperature that needs to be. All right. So the installation of the all-important meat thermometer, which again comes with a pit. We don't believe in upcharging for any of that stuff. You're going to snap it into your control panel here. There's a port on the side.
Okay.
So it feeds right through.
There's like a hole right there. Oh, there it is. There's the hole. And it goes into your
and
meat.
And it goes, look, it reaches all the way.
Oh, my goodness.
To wherever you need
it. Oh, my goodness.
And that's it.
All right, so we're going to use that today.
Absolutely.
All right, now for the fun part. Can we go in and start preparing the food?
Absolutely.
All right, you guys ready to go do the food?